Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Doing something completely different tonight. Got the camera mounted up on a tripod. I'm looking down at the desk where I usually do my recording. I've got the home phonograph set up here. And I just built a new recorder, a Canophonic MP3 transfer recorder. And I was doing some experiments tonight, and I thought, you know, these MP3 transfer recorders are completely different than voice recorders. They're just constructed differently. And I thought I would use one as an acoustic recorder with a speaking tube to see what kind of recording it would make. And I've never done this before. I build voice recorders and I build recorders for the Canophonic MP3 transfer process. And there's such a disparity between them. They're just not the same recorder at all. And I've never really tried to do or even pursued doing acoustic recordings with them. But I did a quick recording tonight that came out surprisingly good. Not because it's extraordinarily loud, but because it's extraordinarily clear. Really, really crisp and precise. Like a tape recorder clear. You would not think that this is the audio is coming off of a 2-minute wax cylinder. And not only that, but I don't know if you can see how thin this cylinder is. Now, this cylinder is so thin that a lot of C reproducers won't even touch it. It is that thin. It is really, really thin. It is about an eighth of an inch thick, and yet my recorder will record on it, which means you can make probably 100 recordings on one of these cylinders. You can record on them again and again and again and again and again and just shave them and shave them and shave them and shave them until there's almost nothing left of them, and yet the recorder will still record on them. That's pretty cool, I think. So what I'm going to do, I've moved the home phonograph over here. I usually record on the standard, and I never record on the home. I've made maybe one or two recordings on this machine. First of all, I don't want to get it dirty. But secondly, I just don't record on it. That's not what I use this for. This is a player only. It's a big, monstrous machine. It does actually make quite a good recorder because you've got such a heavy-duty spring in this thing. This thing's monstrously big, and it has a really powerful spring. So it does actually make a good recorder. But if you remember some of my earlier videos, this machine was junk when I got it. I picked this up for 90 bucks, and it was just absolutely covered with rust and falling apart. It was in pieces. It was an absolute mess. And this is one of my favorite machines. Not because it's so attractive, just because it worked so well and the fact that I saved it. And this machine was junk. I mean, it was trashed. And that always makes for a very special Edison phonograph. Once you've taken a real piece of junk that you've saved from either being parted out or literally thrown out and brought it back to life, and it's sitting here running as an Edison phonograph, is really special. And it's not super attractive. It could be repainted. It could be refinished. The logos are gone. The pinstriping is gone. About the only thing remaining on it that's really legible is the brass nameplate. This machine was trashed, but in any case, when you save one of these machines, they become very special. I wouldn't sell this machine for any price at all. I mean, seriously, if somebody offered me 500 bucks for this machine, I would not sell it. Because I know this machine intimately. I took every single part out of it, broke it all loose, and reassembled it and got it running. Really neat old cylinder phonograph, and it's one of my favorites. This and the standard, when you put this much time and work into something, it becomes valuable to you. Not monetarily, but well, I've got a lot of fond memories of working on this machine, and it works well, and I'm really glad that it works well. But in any case, I'm going to be using it as a recorder. I just wanted to do this a quick recording so you could hear the Canophonic recorder as a voice recorder. Now, I don't do this very often. In fact, I've only made a few recordings with one of the MP3 transfer recorders. They are completely different, but just playing around tonight, I just got this recorder finished. This has only been technically a recorder for 2 hours or so. And I made all the parts myself, except for it has a genuine stylus in it, an Edison stylus. Other than that, every single part in it, I made myself. So anyway, let's make a quick recording with a speaking tube and just do a quick audio or acoustic recording and see what we get. Okay, machine's running. As soon as I drop the stylus, the recording will start. Greetings and salutations. This is Benjamin the Victrola Guy. It is Friday, June the 8th, 2012. It is 1:07 a.m. Just doing a quick recording with one of the Canophonic MP3 transfer recorders. And I'm recording this with a speaking tube. I'm doing an actual acoustic recording with it, something I do not usually do. But I wanted to test one of these to see what they would sound like. Now, when you record acoustically on these, obviously you have to speak much, much louder because these are set up for doing the MP3 Canophonic transfer. But they do make acoustic recordings, and I wanted to make an acoustic recording just to demonstrate how well these work and the clarity of these recordings. So I'm recording this on the Edison Home B cylinder phonograph. I'm recording on a very, very, very thin shaved brown wax cylinder. Recording this with a speaking tube, and I just wanted to do a quick recording to demonstrate what an acoustic recording sounds like using the Canophonic MP3 transfer recorder. So this is Benjamin. It is Friday, June the 8th, 2012. It is now 1:08 a.m. So, always interesting, always experimenting. It's really always interesting to see what you get when you build these recorders. Now I have it's boxed. In fact, let me put it back on its stand. That way there's no fear of it being damaged. Let me grab my witch's hat horn and my swarf brush. Now, as I said, this is a recorder that's used for the MP3 transfer, so not a recorder I use for recording the voice, ever. And I was surprised. You have to talk really loud into them because it's a completely different kind of diaphragm. But the nice thing about them is they make really clear, nice sounding recordings. I hate getting swarf all over this machine. But for the demonstration, it's just something I wanted to do. So we'll grab a Model C reproducer, throw a witch's hat horn on it, and listen to this. Let me get out of the shot. So like I said, as you can see, you have to speak much, much louder because these MP3 transfer recorders are made very differently. They're not made for recording and making an acoustic recording. They're not made for recording the voice. And yet, if you speak loud enough, of course, they actually make quite good recordings. And I was really surprised. It's not something I experiment with as far as the... I've got the voice recorders themselves. Now, the voice recorder is a completely different kind of recorder. In fact, let's do a quick comparison, and I'll show you the difference between the voice recorder and the MP3 transfer recorder. Now, the voice recorder is extremely sensitive, and I put a lot of time and effort into designing and building the voice recorder, because I wanted a recorder for the voice that was extremely sensitive, where you didn't have to raise your voice at all to get a very high quality, good recording. And it's surprising that this cylinder is so small, the voice recorder will not even touch it. So obviously I can't do that. It's interesting to notice, or to note, that the design of these recorders, the styluses, all these original Edison styluses were all handmade. No two are the same. No two diaphragms are the same. No two anything on the original recorders are the same. Unfortunately, until the new styluses get here from Switzerland, I am stuck, if you want to use that word, using the original stylus. There is no replacement for it. You can find replacements for everything else on the Edison recorder, but there is no replacement stylus. There is a company in England called Expert that does sell a 2-minute stylus. They're expensive and they don't work very well, from what I've gathered. I've never seen one. They have an odd shape. They're almost pointed with a chisel end on them. When I had the new styluses made in Switzerland, in fact, that's where they are now, I had them do a line-for-line exact duplicate of the original Edison cup point recorder stylus. I made them out of ruby, of course, rather than sapphire. If I could find a source for sapphire, I would go with sapphire. But sapphires aren't used in industry. Rubies are. So in any case, I just wanted to do a quick experiment with the Canophonic MP3 transfer recorder, and it actually does a fairly good job of recording as an acoustic recorder, if you're willing to shout or speak really loud into this speaking tube. Now, even speaking as loud as I was into this speaking tube, you can see how inefficient this would be if you were trying to record with a recording horn or something like that. But for doing the MP3 transfers, these recorders work extremely well. So just a quick experiment. As I said, I don't usually record acoustically with this recorder, but I wanted to give it a shot, and I figured since I'm going to be playing with it, would be a good time to make a video. I mean, you saw for yourself, I mean, I didn't even know that this cylinder was that small, that the voice recorder wouldn't record on it. As I said, this cylinder is really, really thin. Surprisingly thin. And it's, like I said, getting to the point where the stylus for the reproducer is almost, it's almost too small for the reproducer to play it. So anyway, just a quick video and a quick demonstration of the Canophonic MP3 transfer recorder used as a voice recorder. Not very efficient, but if you're willing to speak loud enough, it actually makes a quite clear and crisp recording. You heard for yourself, the B in Home B was very clear, and it made a very good voice recorder if you're willing to speak loud enough to use it that way, and it would require a speaking tube to do it. But in any case, just a quick test on the Edison Home B, salvaged from junk, using the new MP3 transfer recorder. Just got this one finished. It was under the lamp drying for the last 2 hours or so, so it's only been in use. I've used it, I think, 3 times tonight. So it's still in the process of curing, and by tomorrow it'll be up and running and we can do some real experiments with it. So if you have any questions or comments about anything I've covered in my YouTube series, the MP3 recorder, the voice recorder, the Edison Home B, virtually anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy @gmail.com. Answer all my email, try to answer it the day I get it. Getting a lot of it now, but feel free. I answer every email I get. If I can be of assistance in any way on anything to do with Edison phonographs, Victor phonographs, acoustic phonographs in any way, feel free. Always help in any way I can. So if you have any questions, please feel free. Drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.